morning. Welcome to CYPRUS vlog day 3 or 4. I'm losing track of the days already, and we've only been here a couple of days. We've just sort of hung around by the pool for the last few days, so it's been a little bit quiet. So apologies if there hasn't been much vlogging. We are actually off to a beach club today, so I will try and vlog a little bit more. Just gonna hang around. I really like the sea. Dan doesn't, so I'll probably spend the entire day trying to get him to come in with me. But we're just gonna catch some sun. It's gonna be nice to actually get out of the apartment a little bit. And then because we are out today, we probably won't go out for dinner tonight. So I will catch up with you guys tomorrow. We have just stopped off at the pastry shop because the boys had a bit of a sweet tooth. We did actually come here the other day and I bought a muffin, and I think we bought a massive lemon, was it a lemon cake we bought?
Yeah, lemon drizzle.
But they've got so much stuff here. I think the boys are having something out of this fridge. Let me see what you've got.
Red velvet, Cypriot's finest.
Oh yeah. I don't have a massive sweet tooth, so I normally only go for like cookies or muffins, but there is so much here. I think we should go for 8. 10 to each. Pile them up.
Secure the goods.
Arrived at the Italian. I thought I would quickly jump on and show you my outfit of the night. So my top is H&M, trousers Zara, bag Jacquemus, my sandals are June London, and my jewellery is actually from a brand called D. Louise, which is fast becoming one of my favourite jewellery brands. I'm absolutely obsessed. I've just ordered our food. I'm having seafood risotto, which I will show you in the next clip. And then we're just going to have a chilled one tonight, probably have a bit of a wander down the front. And then we've got an early start because we're off to the beach in the morning. So I will keep you guys with me and show you what we get up to. Hi guys, so we've just arrived at the port. This is where we're going to catch the boat to the Blue Lagoon. I'm with Amy.
Hi guys!
And so I think we're on the boat trip for about 4 hours. We go to, I'm trying to remember now, Bath of Aphrodite, I think it's called, the sea caves, and then we do go to the Blue Lagoon for about 2 hours, where they do like a barbecue, you can go snorkeling and stuff. It might be a bit loud because that boat next to me is about to head off, but I will take you along on the boat trip with me. They are going to be like driving for quite a while. I think it's about an hour till we get to the Blue Lagoon, so I'm probably not going to be able to do any talking videos on the boat because I forgot my little microphone that goes in the top, so it's going to be way too windy. But it's absolutely beautiful there, so I'm really excited to show you it. I've been once before. It was about 4 years ago, I think, pre-COVID, so you can literally see all the way through to the bottom of the water. It's absolutely beautiful. So I will catch up with you guys when we get to the Blue Lagoon. Just about to go and jump off at the Blue Lagoon. It's only about 2 or 3 meters deep, so it's not actually that deep, so I'm a little bit worried. I don't want to jump too hard because I'll probably break my legs. But it's absolutely crystal clear. I'll show you in the next clip how see-through. So we just finished the Blue Lagoon tour, and on the way home we thought we'd take a quick detour to the shipwreck. If you've ever been to Paphos before, you've probably heard of the ship that just literally got stuck in the middle of the sea. So I will show you guys. It's quite far away, so I don't know how clear it'll be on camera, but I'm actually just in my bikini because it was so hot when we got back to the car. I literally couldn't put my clothes back on. I'm just walking out to it now. I thought I could swim to it. I definitely can't. It is miles away. But it's basically just a ship. I think it was like an oil ship. And it just got stuck one day and they physically couldn't get it back out. And the first time I came to Paphos was maybe when I was like 7. So it's been there a really long time because I'm very old now. But I will show you guys. So I'm just going to zoom in and see if it captures it any better. It's quite far out, so you probably aren't able to see it that clearly. It's quite a big ship, and as you can see, it just got stuck literally in the middle of the sea. Well, not in the middle of the sea, but you know, quite far out. You definitely couldn't swim to it, I don't think, but you're also not allowed to. But yeah, it's just in the middle of the ocean. So I'm just going to try and take a walk out. As you can see, it's very rocky and I'm literally in Havanas, is that what they're called?
Costa del Sol.
So, my sister, oh god, nearly fell. My sister calls them Costa del Sols. I'm just going to try and take a walk out. Well, this is deadly in a bikini, guys. If I fall over, it is game over. Oh, this is so sketchy. Hiking could definitely not be my next career, I'm telling you. Camera's gonna pick it up. There's a little fishy.
So I'm really sorry I didn't manage to do any vlogging today. We have literally just been by the pool trying to get our tans up, so nothing exciting's happened. And then we're just off for dinner now to a local restaurant that's literally like a 5-minute walk from the apartment. It's called Pambis. We've been once before and the food was really nice, so hopefully it's still the same. We've got a few busy days ahead, so we're just gonna have a chilled one tonight as well. I will try and show you my food, but my battery is literally about to die, so hopefully I manage to get some charge before we leave. And I will pop a quick outfit of the evening on as well to show you what I'm wearing.
So, quick outfit of the day. My actual full outfit is from PLT. Hey Dan. My bag is Primark. It's actually a really cute, like, raffia style bag. And then my shoes, sorry, the mirror's not great, are from June London. They're a bit like the Hermes sandals, but for a fraction of the price. And then my jewellery again is D. Louise. Sure how well you can see me, because obviously it's quite dark out here, but I'm whispering because we've just decided, now we've got back from the restaurant, that we are going to go in the pool. And I think that you're allowed in until like 8 o'clock at night, and it's now midnight, and some of the people around the apartments are quite strict. So we're going to try and have a late night swim, and hope that nobody comes and tells us off. I will try and get some videos of us in the pool. I really need to try my camera in the waterproof case, but it does give me severe anxiety. But yeah, I'll try and get some clips. Sorry, I don't know why it's not focusing. We have just arrived at Cabana Beach Club. I've just ordered a strawberry daiquiri, which is actually my first cocktail of the holiday, which I'm a little bit ashamed to admit. Amy's got a passion fruit mojito. So we're gonna just chill out here for the day. It's actually really, really nice here. I'll do a little like mini tour in a minute. And then in about 40 minutes the food opens, so we're gonna order some food and then we're just gonna chill out, sunbathe, possibly get a little bit of content because literally everywhere you look is beautiful. And then we'll just try and top our tans up.
Cheers.
In the bathroom, so I thought I would use it to show you my outfit of the day. You know, you have those few outfits that you pack that you're like, I literally can't wait to wear it. This is one of mine. I think it's all I saw at first, bikini and trousers. They're like the ripped style, which my grandpa would have an absolute field day on. And then my shoes are June London, and my sunglasses, I actually think they're from Amazon, but I'll try and find the link and link it below. But this is by far one of my favourite holiday outfits, and this is like the perfect location, beach club vibes, to wear it. Have just arrived in Napa. We made a little bit of like an impulsive decision when we landed in Cyprus to go to Napa for the night. I haven't been, my sister's actually been once before, and I don't think the boys have been, so we're gonna head down to the strip and have a bit of a party night out. None of us have got drunk on this holiday, which it's actually quite surprising, but yeah, so we're gonna get a little bit drunk and have a little bit of a night out. I think we are a little bit old for it, but who cares. We've just checked into the hotel, which is called So White Club Resort. I will insert a few bits and bobs of the hotel and show you what it's like. Obviously I can't give a review at the moment because we have just arrived. So far looks really nice. I'll show you the pool area that I'm sat at in a minute. Take on a little bit of a tour of the hotel and then I will catch you guys tonight when we head out for Napa.
That's where I was laying. This is the pool area. They've got like floating sunbeds and then really cute hammocks. There's Dan. Say hi, Dan. Are you asleep? I thought you was asleep. And then over here, they've got like little villas, I think, or like rooms where you've got your own pool. I'm not going to be able to show too much because obviously it's people's rooms. So that's their pool areas. And they've got this like cafe seating area bit. There's Amy and Dan over there. I don't know if you can see them. They're in a deep conversation. So this will actually be as much as a tour for you as it will be for me, because this is my first time walking around as well. But this looks like there's another pool area over here.
So we've just got the keys to our room. We've actually been given the wrong room at the moment, but it's looking like we're going to be keeping this one. So I thought I would just do a quick show around. So there's a little bathroom there, nothing special, just a small toilet. Then this is the shower. And then this is me, hi. And then the reason the room isn't right is because it's supposed to be two double bedrooms, but we seem to have been given a room with one bedroom and then they've just popped beds in the room. And then this is the bedroom. Me again. Then we have got a pool view, they call it, but it's a private pool.
little cute balcony area, and then we've just got a pool. There's Amy. I'll do a quick outfit of the day while I'm in front of a mirror. So my bikini is from Hunza G. My shirt is from Nadia's Edit with Marble Swimwear. Shorts are H&M, and my shoes are from M&S. This is actually my first time wearing them. They're a little bit uncomfortable, so I think they're gonna need some wearing in. And my sunglasses are from Primark. We are on Ayia Napa day 2. I am completely hungover free because last night was a very unsuccessful night. So Dan didn't feel very well. He actually felt really sick. We're not quite sure why. Maybe he had a little bit of heat stroke. So we actually only ended up going out for one drink, and then we just got a load of crappy takeaway food and ate it in the room, which actually in my opinion is a pretty successful night. But yeah, so we didn't really go very hard last night, but a little bit of an update for you guys. So we obviously we had to wait a really long time for the room yesterday. It was just so busy in reception. We ended up waiting, so we came and checked in at like 11, but we couldn't go to our room until I think she said like 1:30, but we didn't actually end up getting into our room until it was about 4:30. So we lost quite a lot of the day. So the lady obviously sorted out the room because it was the wrong one, gave us two rooms, and then she also extended our stay by another day. So we're here till Monday now, so we'll be here tonight as well, and then we'll go back to the other apartment tomorrow, which I guess is a win-win. And then also she gave us all inclusive, so I mean it was a bit annoying that we had to wait around, but I don't really mind. It was worth it in the end, I guess. Dan is just coming out the shower if you hear a load of crashing and banging. So I'm not quite sure what we're gonna end up doing tonight. We're gonna chill by the pool today, and then we might try round 2 tomorrow, tonight, but we'll see how we go. Because of all the problems we had yesterday, if they've not already done enough, they've now sort of upgraded us. They've just given us a new room for the second day's stay. So we're just moving all of our stuff down now. It's slightly bigger than the room we've already got, so I'm gonna quickly give you a room tour. It's very similar to the last one, but just a little bit bigger. So I will insert a few clips now and show you guys. We'll be right back. quickly show you my outfit of the night before we head to dinner. I thought I'd better document it as it is a colourful one. Yeah, I thought I'd better show you guys as it's colourful and I actually really love it. This corset fits really nicely, it's not too tight. But yeah, I am wearing heels, which are likely to be changed into sandals in about 2 minutes. But we're just gonna head off to dinner now, so I will probably catch up with you guys tomorrow. I will try and film anything that we get up to tonight. So we have just come to the fair in Ayia, Napa. Is it a fair? Is that what you call it? Fun fair? Is
yeah, it's like a better version.
With like roller coasters and stuff. So we're just debating whether we go on any rides. But yeah.
This is the first day that we've actually woken up in time for breakfast. We're just waiting for Amy and Dan to wake up so they can come and join us. And then we're going to have a little lay in the sun, I think, today, as it is our last day in Ayia Napa. We're going to have that tonight, so need to get a little bit of a tan before we leave. Day. So this dress is from Nasty Gal and then I'm just wearing some Primark sliders because
this is from H&M. My shoes are from JD, H&M and Ray-Ban.
Nice. So let's try that again. So my dress is from Nasty Gal, my shoes are from Primark because we're going to be on like really rough roads and steep hills. I don't want to take any of my good shoes. I'll try and show you the back quickly. It's like backless, which is really cute. So this is our cart for Adonis Falls. We had to change it because you're not allowed to take the hire cart up on the rough roads. So this is our ride for the day. Off to have a look at the view. So we are just on the road to Adonis Falls and I literally can't video anything. We have just arrived at Adonis Falls. It was so rocky, I'm not sure how much content I can use that I got on the way up here. It is so like off-road, I was being thrown all over the car, so I don't think I'm going to be able to use any of it. But I think you have to pay to get in now, so we're just going to pay and then head down. It's like a natural waterfall that's been there for forever, so we will show you around when